video I'm going to talk about various cards which can be played against control decks. The biggest offender is Force of Negation. With a free counter spells, those decks aren't scared to tap out anymore, so you should avoid playing non-creature spells. Switch from playing Primal Commands to Fierce Empaths. You can't find reasonable counterparts to Auras, Planeswalkers and Tooth and Nail itself, so they have to stay. There's a bunch of cards one could play against control, but not all of them are worth playing. Veil of Summer might seem like the obvious and best possible spell to play against control and discard, but it isn't. First off, individually, it does nothing. It needs a card it can protect, so it's turning Tooth and Nail from one card combo into two cards combo. Drawing a card from it is irrelevant. If you want to know why, watch my video about card selection in Tooth and Nail. Additionally, Veil doesn't do anything to Aethergast and Cryptic Command with tap and draw modes. Guttural Response can counter both. I even tried Negate in Timur versions, but one look at Teferi Time Raveler was enough to realize it's pointless to play those cards. Some creatures prevent your opponents from countering your spells. Those are Vexing Shusher, Dosan the Falling Leaf, Dragonlord Dromoka, and one that's a little different but still has similar effect, Ruriktar the Unbowed. Unfortunately, they are all gone with one removal spell, so they are not the answers. They just protect your other cards. Boseiju, who shelters all, can make Tooth and Nail uncounterable, and it costs 2 life per use. It also enters the battlefield tapped, and you should avoid playing tap lands in Tooth and Nail at all costs. Because Boseiju enters tapped, opponent can destroy it with Field of Ruin before you even have a chance to use it. Chandra, Awakened Inferno is way too slow. And now that control has access to such things as Force of Negation, Aethergast and Bounce from Teferi, Blood Moon isn't as good as it used to be, but can still be decent under right conditions. Sometimes it will work, sometimes it won't. You can also try casting Panglacial Worm at opponent's end stamp from Fetchland to bait out a counterspell. It is best when you have something else to follow up next turn. Remember, you can also cast it when one of your creatures gets buffed. Control likes to interact a lot, so there will be lots of targets for Eternal Witness. Generally, creatures are the best answers to control in green, because you can easily tutor them in this color, unlike other card types. The best type of such creatures are those uncounterable with hexproof. Sphinx of the Final Ward seems playable, but I haven't tested it myself. If you're not playing Primal Commands, your only instant and sorceries would be 4 or 3 copies of Tooth and Nail. Thran is cheap and can be regenerated, which can matter because Wrath of God has been replaced by Supreme Verdict, but he ends games very slowly. Carnage Tyrant is faster, it's also bigger and has trample. Gaea's Revenge has 8 power, it's playable, but can't be targeted with Kessig Wolfram. Probably the best creature to play against control is Crackplate Balof, because it has haste and can be kicked, so so it's a monster late game. Creatures like this are the best way to fight control, but they have two weaknesses. Various sweepers and blockers with death touch. Some Eldrazis are fine too. Ulamog usually gets countered, but it still exiles two permanents. Emrakul the Aeon's Thorn, on the other hand, almost always win you the game. When you're facing a control deck, you should sideboard out one of your worst mana dorks, especially if your opponent plays Path to Exile, because game will go long anyway. If you're splashing blue, Glen Elendra Archmage is a great choice. That's two negates even under a small Teferi. So, those were few ways to fight control decks.